Hi, I'm Nicole, and it's day three of Paws Fest 2017. We're with Channel 31 here at Fed Square today. We hope to cover some really interesting talks on information and technology. So we're here today at Baja Board with Rochelle, and she's just going to talk us through this beautiful design. Tell us about Baja Board and how it came to be. The history of it.
Yeah, Baja Board's an off-road electric skateboard. Goes up 55 k's an hour, so you go pretty fast on it. Really exciting. It's designed, built and tested in Melbourne. It came from one of the co-founders, James. Thought he would come up with an idea for a car and thought, bit big, let's go for something that's a little bit smaller where we can test out a few different things. So James used to build skateboards. He's a snowboarder and he's a semi-pro RC car racer. So you can see a lot of the components that he's taken, you know, dynamics of snowboarding, the design of cars and, you know, the decks of skateboarding, put that all together to create something completely unique. It has got a patent pending on it as well, but something that people could really enjoy and go off-road and explore where no one else has been able to explore before. So yeah, it's actually really, really easy to use. As you can see probably in front of us, the wheels are quite large and it's a very, very stable board. So we've had people who have never ridden a skateboard or a snowboard or anything similar before, and after, you know, a good hour, they're able to ride quite comfortably on their own. Yeah. So basically stop and go, your main controls, but you can change a whole lot of other things on here as well. You can go backwards on it, which is quite fun. But if you're into like drifting or you want to do burnouts, all that kind of stuff, if you want to launch, it goes from 0 to 30 in under 2 seconds. You can change all those settings within this controller and even the lights and things like that. So you can really ride the way that you want to ride.
We're here with Daniel from Dropbox, and he's just going to tell us a little bit about himself and the company and how it came to be. How are you going today?
Yeah, good, Nicole. Thank you. So I'm Daniel Iverson. I lead the solution architects at Dropbox here for the APAC regions. It actually started with our founder being on a bus, wanting to do some work for 4 hours and realized that he didn't have his USB stick with him. And so he thought there should be a simpler way. And so he started creating Dropbox on that bus ride. And so very quickly, Dropbox kind of became the home for your most important stuff, and it was about keeping your files in sync. But then over the years, it really turned into a collaboration platform, and so now it's really around keeping teams in sync. And so that's where we have the enterprise product that we've had for a while, and the business product we've had for 4 years now, and where we're seeing really a lot of growth and traction in our business. So we obviously can't predict the future, but really sort of connecting teams, connecting people, and really being that connective tissue in between applications, devices, and people, and simplifying the way people work together. That's what we're about.
So we're here with Alita Harvey Rodriguez, who's the head of marketing and on the board of directors for Girls in Tech. How are you going today?
Good, thank you.
Good. So can you just tell us a little bit about Girls in Tech and what you guys are doing at Paws in this year?
Yeah, so Girls in Tech is a global organisation. It exists in about 60 countries around the world, and we are here for the empowerment of and supporting young women through their careers in STEM fields.
Over the last few days, there's been some amazing talks on. What's some talks that have stood out to you?
Yeah, I think the talk that Alicia Naples did talking about the unintended consequences of innovation was a really interesting conversation, and it's exactly what Girls in Tech is here to talk about at Paws. Do tech and empathy really belong together? And as innovation continues to evolve, it becomes more and more obvious that we really need to address not only social issues, but we also need to address the development of empathy within our artificial intelligence systems as well. Mm.
So in terms of empathy, let's unpack that a little bit. Specifically, what does that mean?
Yeah, well, it means a variety of things. It's everything from legislation. We're talking about predictive policing now. We're also, you know, who governance of news and fake news. We've seen a lot of that with the wrap-up of the US election. You know, citizen news, you know, citizen reporters and things like that. As well as innovation in disruptive industries. So for example, Uber have just recently sent out their first driverless truck. What about the, yeah, which is really cool, right? But what are the actual consequences of that innovation? We're not just talking about truck drivers that are disrupted. We're also talking about retail, and we're talking about petrol stations. We're talking about all sorts of things on a greater economic impact. How do we actually manage these things as we continue to innovate, but without having the skills to drive this innovation forward? How do we actually tackle these things from an empathetic and a human level? It's really something that we need to talk about more rapidly and more often about the human and economic impact that tech innovation is having.
So that concludes our coverage of PauseFest 2017. It's been a great few days. It's been some amazing conversations around creativity, business and technology. See you guys next year.